Good afternoon, dear students. Here in this experiment, I am going to tell you how to determine the total alkalinity of a water sample. Now, what is total alkalinity? Total alkalinity of water is the measure of ability of water to neutralize a strong acid. Now, alkalinity of water, the water becomes alkaline. Why? Alkalinity of water may be due to presence of one or more number of ions. What are those? Alkalinity of water may be because of hydroxide ions, carbonates and bicarbonates. Alkalinity of water may be also because of dissolution of carbon dioxide in water. Salts like silicates, phosphates, borates also produce alkalinity in water. Alkalinity in water maintains the growth of various microbial flora in water. Okay. Now, if you want to determine the total alkalinity of a water, how to do that? Now, total alkalinity sometimes may be interfering. Now, alkalinity values provide guidelines in applying proper class of chemicals in water and wastewater treatment, particularly during coagulation and water softening, right? So, alkalinity of water should be known because it is going to provide you a guideline of how to soften the water or how particular treatment like coagulation can be given for purification of water. Now, alkalinity is an important factor because it buffers against rapid pH changes in water. However, large amount of alkalinity imparts bitter taste in water. So, how to determine the alkalinity of water? What is the principle behind it? Now, total alkalinity of water is determined by titration. Here, we are going to study how to determine the total alkalinity by titration. Titration is done with a standard acid, that is H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Now, titration of the water sample to pH 8.3 or decolorization of phenolphthalein indicator indicates complete neutralization of hydroxyl ions and half of carbonate ions. This titration is followed by second titration. So, titration to a pH of 4.3, titration to a pH of 4.3 or a sharp color change of methyl orange indicator indicates complete neutralization of carbonate and bicarbonate ions. So, the first titration, you take the water sample, add phenolphthalein indicator, titrate with H2SO4, and when the titration reaches a point of 8.3, the color of phenolphthalein will disappear and it indicates neutralization of hydroxyl ions and half of carbonate ions. And the first titration provides alkalinity, which is called as phenolphthalein alkalinity. It is designated by the letter capital P. The second titration provides alkalinity, which is called as methyl orange alkalinity, and it is designated as MO. The total alkalinity is determined by adding these two values, that is phenolphthalein alkalinity P plus methyl orange alkalinity MO will give you total alkalinity, that is T. So, what are the chemicals that you require? Phenolphthalein indicator, methyl orange indicator and 0.02 normal sulfuric acid. And of course, the water sample whose alkalinity is to be determined. So, what is the procedure? You take a conical flask, okay, clean and dry conical flask. In the conical flask, what we will add? 25 ml of water sample. What you will add? 25 ml of water sample. And to the flask, you are going to add 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. What are you going to add? 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Now, after adding phenolphthalein indicator, if pink color develops in the water, if pink color develops, you have to titrate it with 0.02 normal H2SO4 till the color disappears, till the pink color disappears. That means the water will again become as it is, transparent. Okay, and that reading is reported as A, that is volume of H2SO4 required to remove the color of phenolphthalein, right? So, that is the first titration. Now, to the same flask, you have to add 2 to 3 drops of methyl orange indicator, okay? To the same flask, you are going to add 2 to 3 drops of methyl orange indicator. When you add methyl orange indicator, the color of the water will become yellow. Okay, it will become yellow. Now you fill the burette again with H2SO4. Now titrate it with H2SO4, 0.02 normal H2SO4, till there is a sharp color change from yellow to orange. And now note the reading. The second reading is reported as B. So for phenolphthalein alkalinity, you take 25 ml of water sample, titrate with H2SO4 and determine how much amount of H2SO4 is required, and the first reading is reported as A. Volume of H2SO4 required for neutralization of hydroxyl and half of carbonate ions. Then the second titration, that is for methyl orange alkalinity. It is, the end point here is indicated by the letter B. Okay, you determine the volume of H2SO4 required for change in the color of methyl orange indicator from yellow to orange. Right? And then the calculation. So phenolphthalein alkalinity P, as CaCO3 in mg per liter is equal to A into 1000 upon volume of water sample taken, because you are calculating it for liter. And methyl orange alkalinity is B into 1000 upon volume of water. And then the total alkalinity is P plus MO. Okay. So that is how you determine the total alkalinity of any water sample. Is that clear? So you calculate the amount of alkalinity and report it as total alkalinity of any water sample. So that is all about determination of alkalinity in a water sample.